I love seeing comics
right.
do things that are not traditional. You know, when I, for me coming up, Robin Williams could be in a, you know, a drama, Jim Carrey, Eternal Sunshine. Or, there's so many comics that played roles that, you know, Michael Keaton was a comedian. He was Michael Douglas, comedian.
That's right. Comedy store regular.
And so I, for me, I like seeing the departure moments in any comic, any guy or girl that's out there that is primarily known as, you know, a joke slinger. I love seeing somebody in losing them in a role going, wow, that is them. I know them and I forgot it was them.
Well, that's kind of my point is the fact that, because I completely understand. I think that you're probably, I mean, it seems like it's made you healthier to go to the Zen kind of attitude that you've been doing lately. But it's also, I think, okay to let people know, hey, let them know I'm a big Star Wars fan. Because if Favreau's producing, have you worked with Favreau before?
I mean, I've met him.
Okay,
met,
because I feel like you have those new Disney Plus shows that are coming out, whether it's The Mandalorian
Or Marvel stuff.
The Cassian Andor. But I think that this is also, by doing like something like American Exit, it's a different way now for you to kind of get in the door of this thing, as opposed to saying like, well, there's, you know, Dane from selling out Radio City Musical. But now it's, check this out.
Yeah, and it's also like, you know, I can only talk about kind of how my career happened. It's like when you hit that highest high point, the upper, you know, the top spot. And I've talked about this with Steve Martin. I've talked about this with Andrew Dice Clay. It's like, okay, that crest breaks. And then, of course, people want to write and say, like, they're done. That's that they had their moment. We all know that that's hullabaloo. That's like, it's crazy. No, they're going to reinvent, rebuild. And then the story is they're back.
People love comebacks.
Yeah, oh, it's the American way.
Look at John Travolta. You mentioned Pulp Fiction before.
Everybody, literally, Will Smith, everybody.
Yeah.
And of course, me. So once that pressure was off, even though there was so much good that came out of it, I was kind of like, okay, I put a nest egg aside. I'm okay financially. Comedy will always pay the rent. Now I can say no to all that stuff that I think is, you know, half-baked. And I can be patient, sometimes excruciatingly patient, and wait for things that I really am want to revel in and enjoy. So, yeah, hopefully this will parlay into whatever that is, but I'm not pushing it.
Yeah.
I'll let it, you know, come to me, so to speak.
Yeah, I remember I had I don't remember which interview it was, but I remember you talking about during that time that, and it's also, and this happened to Dice, happened to everybody, when you blow up there too, there's, when you walk into the comedy clubs, you feel like every comedian is looking at you, maybe not in the best way too, whether it's a jealousy thing, maybe it's a, and I remember at one point it felt that, you know, whether not everybody was on your side, but now it seems like it's shifted. It seems like you've...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I was guilty. I did the same thing to people. I can't be a hypocrite. I had thoughts of being like, I'm tired of seeing this person and kind of prejudging. But it's funny. This is like where I feel like the old bull, and I'm like, man, I've been around for a minute. I'm not the 19-year-old kid anymore from Boston. But the goodwill... And the amount of people that have come to me, whether in comedians in clubs or writing me and saying, hey, man, I'm one of those people. I jumped on you, too. And then they give me their reasons why, and I'm completely understanding. I can actually go like, oh, I empathize with that. I know what it felt like to have nothing and be kind of jealous. Or I knew what it felt like to feel like, man, my little crumb turned into nothing, and then this person who's only been doing it a minute suddenly has the golden horseshoe up their ass. Because you start to understand there's no rhyme or reason with the whole thing. It's really just hard work, persistence.
Yeah, and when the universe wants to take
a little bit of luck.
Yeah,
I mean, I subscribe to the idea that, you know, if you work harder and longer and also cultivate something that is in a niche, I think you greater your chances of making a landing pad that you can hit. But all that stuff, all that the highest wave and the mentorship that I got from a lot of people, and now how I can mentor, you know, young, not just comedians, I'm friends with all kinds of artists, but because of the mistakes that I made or the things that just happened to me that I wasn't cognizant of at the time.
Yeah.
All those things, I feel like a Jedi now.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I'm so centered.
Yeah.
I'm not thinking that far ahead or behind. I just want to make what I'm doing today fantastic.